And now to some developing news for you tonight. We've learned more about the case against a Columbus music producer once thought to be a robbery victim, but now charged with sexually exploiting young boys. News Leader 9's Dante Renzulli spoke to an attorney who explains the details of Stevie Porter's undoing. Dante?
Well, as a Columbus attorney describes it, Stevie Porter's activities may have never been discovered if he didn't cry wolf one too many times. When we spoke to the accused child pornographer last month, he didn't want his face shown and portrayed himself as the victim of a violent robbery. He alleged his attackers stole his electronics and targeted him as part of a gang initiation or possibly a hate crime. But a Columbus attorney has a different take on that story.
Initially, all he wanted was his laptop and the phone, and I can understand why. He insisted on prosecuting this case. Mr. Porter had an opportunity to get his items back without this matter going forward through an investigation. This is a house where young people frequent to engage in activity they perhaps couldn't engage in at home otherwise, drinking alcohol.
Now, attorney Whitaker says his client was one of several juveniles invited by Porter to his house for underage drinking. At one point, the teenager asked to use Porter's phone because his battery had died, and that's when he noticed a suggestive picture of his own rear end, fully clothed, but taken when he wasn't looking. The teenager was so alarmed by the discovery, he and his friends left Porter's house, but not before taking his phone and his laptop to see if there were any more pictures. And it turned out there were a lot more pictures. Attorney Whitaker didn't see any of the pictures himself, but police tell him that the evidence his clients turned into police show that Porter has victimized many young boys in the community in much more explicit ways. Coming up at 6, we'll hear